I think that to learn to work, to learn to get the real rewards from the work itself, to set one's own goals and try to match those, which should be higher than what comes from the outside, is always fascinating. Now, in the studio, which my husband founded and which I joined in 1947, we work really and truly for the pleasure of the work itself, and that's why it's so exciting. I have never, not since I've started teaching, or from the time I was teaching about 2 years, I stopped making judgments on who is or who isn't talented because I've been wrong too often. So has everybody else. I think that's the most fatal thing you can do, say you have no talent, get out of the theater. I may say get out of my class because you're a lazy bum, because you're an alibier, because you buck pass, because you put the responsibility on somebody else, because you have a rotten character. That I may throw somebody out for, but I would never presume to say you have no talent. Now, I choose someone at auditions on the basis of what something in that actor that interests me. It may be, for that moment, my evaluation of their talent. But it goes way beyond that, as I just said. And I've never in my life, since I'm 28, maybe I never did before that either, say to somebody, you should get out of the theater. I think that acting teachers who do that should be spanked.
Nothing is too much if it has reality. What is too much is pushing, mugging, illustrating, indicating is too much, is wrong. But a full experience, no matter how huge it can be, is not too much in my opinion.
Where the hell is everybody? So, drop me. Pluck me like a goddamn whatever it is creeping vine. Throw me over your shoulder like an old shoe. George! George! What are you doing, hiding or something? George! Oh, for Christ. Deserted. Abandoned. Left out in the cold like an old pussycat. Can I get you a drink, Martha? Why, thank you, George. That's very kind of you. No, no, Martha. I'd do anything for you. Would you, George? I'd do anything for you, too. Would you, Martha? Why, certainly, George. Martha, I've misjudged you. And I've misjudged you too, George. Where the hell is everybody?